And we're across to Wales, to Presteigne. And to the railway station, where we all foregather for some driving tests. This is for vintage only, no PVTs, no post-vintage thoroughbreds on the Welsh trial. Quite cold weather, but the Hampton was steaming a bit. Rolls-Royce, not competing up the hills, but doing the driving tests. Fine Mercedes. And an equally fine Bentley. There's the GN of Riddle. That is eminently suitable for mud plugging. Rolls, less so, and it's only here for the driving tests. An Edwardian Rolls-Royce, a very rare collector's item. Collector's item too is the Bugatti, but used a little bit more fiercely. And as we travel down the main street in Presteigne, it looks as if the world has moved back 40 years. Radnorshire Arms are centre of activities for the weekend, and it's a very family affair. Hamish Moffat is under the Brescia Bugatti doing a bit of tweaking. Peter Hull, who's competition secretary in charge of the weekend. And there's one way to change a wheel. Lots of Austin 7 specials, ideally suited for mud plugging. And we're foregathered at the first hill. During the day, competitors will cover maybe 12 hills. There's somebody buying a car in installments. Hamish Moffat is away, always very competitive in the Brescia Bugatti. And Tim Carson, club secretary, makes certain that everything works according to the clock. First hill, quite misty, but not difficult to find your way up. Light cars can compensate for lack of power by being a bit nimble. Elvis 1250 normally makes its way up the hill, but not today. The conditions are quite greasy after rain. Austin 7s have more success. Hamish Moffat and the Bugatti. No trouble at all on Hill 1. To get up a hill, you need very little tire pressure, but then for the roads, you need the pressure up again. A very nice Segato-bodied Alpha finds its way halfway up, but then struggles and drops a bit of exhaust pipe. Plenty of helpers, and the bits are returned to the driver. The 3098 Vauxhall has the advantage of four seats, so extra bouncers. But unfortunately, not getting to the top today. A Jowett, who doesn't seem to have any shock absorbers, has a beautiful bounce, but doesn't get much further. It was a very slimy day, but a very enjoyable day, which brought our film to an end. For the club year. Last people up the last hill. And we're thinking about the winter when we may have to rebuild the motor car, do a bit of fettling and prepare for the next year. 1962 had been a most successful year for the Vintage Sports Car Club, and the last meeting of the year in the middle of Wales provided plenty of enjoyment for spectators and competitors alike. This traditionally is the last hill of the year, it's Smatcher. And it's a matter of honour to try and get to the top of this very difficult hill. Hamish Moffat, as ever, shows how it's done in the Bugatti, and we say farewell to the club film for another year.